America is a country where I really want to be more present.
Believe me, just one look at this necklace and they're going to be flocking to you.
This necklace was actually designed thinking of Marie Antoinette, the Queen of France.
Yes.
She loves roses, and the French people were just in love with her, and we're creating a special breed of rose that was different from the other, almost like the canine rose, almost like the wild rose. So this necklace is a little bit an homage of femininity and of
her. This is... It's a dream to be able to wear this necklace.
Thank you. Also, the center, it can be detached, and this is a part of my characteristic. The two dangling parts here can be detached, so you can wear the necklace in a more casual way.
Right.
The small one become the left earrings, then you have a clasp that can allow you to be worn on the back also as a flower. The clasp is also becoming an earring here with this thing, and always look at our little butterfly is another rose.
Oh,
you see, it's engraved
goodness.
Like a rose.
Yes.
And also you can lock the earring movement, and it's also a little brooch. So you can have two large or three brooch all together.
So by the way, in case you haven't figured it out yet, this is Alessio Boschi.
Oh, thank you. You pronounce it very well, because out of Italy, S-C-H is sh. And everybody, Alessio Boschi. No, it's Boschi. It's Boschi.
Boschi.
Like, imagine you have a K, but in Italy we are cuckoo. We don't have this K, middle of vowel alphabet. So,
Yes,
it's Alessio Boschi.
Alessio
you pronounce
Boschi.
It very well. Thank you very
and
much.
And he is just a mind-boggling designer, a very enigmatic,
thank you.
Energetic, outrageously creative person.
Thank you very
and,
much.
And he did not pay me to say that either. And I just met Alessio, and I am so excited. Yeah, I mean, it's really, but that does make me want to ask you.
Yes.
Clearly, you are a very creative, artistic person.
Thank you.
What made you choose jewelry as your medium for expressing your creativity?
That's a very interesting question. I think it was always in my blood, and I didn't know. I'm from Rome, and it's very important that I'm from Rome for one characteristic. I think we live in one of the most baroque cities in the world.
Yes.
Many civilizations, many artistic people and period have gone through, but also it's a city of surprise. Now, you have to imagine when Bernini, Borromini, and all the other artists, they were creating this beautiful fountain, no, full of explosion of colors and water and marble. And you were entering those squares, those baroque squares by a little road. And then you start hearing at the water, you know, and they say, what? You start wondering. And then you are in front of Fontana di Trevi.
Yes.
Oh my God, you know, it's like, wow. What's that? I think this is a little bit what is left over in my blood.
I think that's a lot of what's left over in your blood.
Thank
because
you.
What y'all are about to see is some very incredible little surprises in this jewelry. So, well, I loved hearing about the cameo.
Oh, yes. That's
so,
yes.
I would love for you to share with these guys.
So, two years ago, I started a collection which is called The Precious Journey. And it was a collection that it was inspired by some icon, monument of our Italian city, because from 1780 to 1920, Italy was the center of the Grand Tour. So intellectuals from all over the world were passing through Italy, but they would stay like 6 months, 1 year, 2 years. It's also the period where the micro mosaic start. It's the period of Romanticism, it's Napoleon period, it's the Empire, it's the Dandy, Victorian.
Yeah.
You know, it was a period of extremely fervent.
My favorite 19th
century.
Period, by the way.
Yeah, and it was the period of Neoclassicism also. We are in Vicenza, the city of Neoclassicism, with Palladio and great other artists, Canova around. Mm-hmm. And it's the period where Antonio Canova in Rome was the biggest artist, sculpture of the Neoclassic. Mm-hmm. His pupil, Thorvaldsen, he was also a fantastic sculptor, and they became very close friends. In 1833, I think 1833, Canova died, mm-hmm. and for the next 40 years, Thorvaldsen becoming one of the biggest artists of Europe, taking the juice from what he had learned right. and exchange with Canova. In front of the studio of Canova, there was a studio of Tommaso and Luigi Saulini. I decided here to go deeper to the Grand Tour mm-hmm. and purchase some antique piece made during the Grand Tour period and refreshing them on style, a little bit like Castellani did right. in the 19th
That's
century.
Amazing.
And I try, okay, let's challenge myself. I have such a great respect for the antique, I would never dismiss or take out parts. So
right.
this necklace took me 8 months to be accomplished correctly.
Wow.
And I'm here today to show
goodness
you.
Goodness gracious.
First of all, I want to show you this image is one
Maybe.
Of the monuments, one of the sculpture of Thorvaldsen,
okay.
and is preserved in Copenhagen Museum. And here we have a reproduction by the Saulini family of this cameo. I didn't have idea what I was going to purchase that day in the antique
wow.
shop in Rome
that
until I saw
exquisite.
This mozart, this cameo, and I just frozen.
Yeah.
I was there frozen and I said, oh my God, I never see a cameo so beautiful where even the coat is, the transparency of the coat is mm-hmm. such a delicate mm-hmm. matter. And you want me to put it on you? And then we can just
well,
cut
yeah,
the
I mean,
part?
Of
yeah,
course.
Why not? Oh,
wow. Wow.
Those one are basically 18 strands of pearls and rubellite beads. The
yeah.
difficulty was to find all of them matching in color from 2 millimeter on the back to 6 millimeter up. And they are like, look, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So they are 6 and 6, 12 strands. And plus you have the strands in the middle.
Yeah.
Also you can remove the center if you don't want to be like a tassel like this, which
okay.
is perfect for your dress.
Right.
But let's say you have a different kind of dress and you found this part. So you can remove the tassel
wow.
and the tassel itself as a system where you insert here the
chain,
and you can have yeah. it as an enhancer
wow.
worn like this. And the motifs that you see here are all the motifs, the classic motif, the palmette design, which was influenced by
uh-huh.
the Persian ancient and traveling to the Egyptian and then finally reached the Greeks. And you
wow.
see on the front of the temples and the decoration
uh-huh.
of the Greek and Roman art, because it is about neoclassicism.
Right.
So it's about taking back little bit like the Renaissance, no? The
mm-hmm.
Renaissance for
right.
Michelangelo, Raphael, Leonardo, and all the other greats. It was a period where they discovered Pompeii, was the period where there was the love for the ancient again, Renaissance,
right.
born
right.
again. I want to show you the secret of this necklace, though.
I want to
show you
yes.
what happened to this necklace. What I do here is I unlock the cameo, because as you may be not able to see clearly, I did not touch the original 1850 piece
wow.
with the gold, with the patina. I didn't even polish the gold because I want to leave the patina. And
wow.
when I purchased the cameo, I purchased it full. So it was already a brooch. And this is the original brooch. The
wow.
way that
That's
it
amazing.
Was done, you see,
mm-hmm.
is very simple,
yeah.
but it's efficient. And
wow.
then what happened to our necklace? Our necklace, below our necklace,
wow.
there is an hand engraved acanthus leaves. In the Neoclassic, you see
wow.
a lot of those elements. But
incredible.
If you wear the necklace like this, to me, it was like something is missing. Definitely, you know that there was something. And so I decide to apply what is my style, the surprise element. I thought that something would be just empty, you know, is incomplete. What I did is there is a basculating system, so a flip over system, which
oh my gosh,
as here we are talking about the sunrise in the neoclassic period of Canova, Tolvalzen and Saulini, here we are looking at the day and night of Michelangelo. There is a liaison.
Yes.
And it's all about the classic again.
Right.
But interpreted in different way. And so now, which I flip the necklace, you see here what happened, and you can see the night and day of Michelangelo with Rubellite, like a tutti frutti style.
Oh my gosh, that is stunning.
They explained to me a little bit about the unicity of this cameo, and then at the end of my conversation I decided to buy this masterpiece with some sacrifice, I would say.
I'm sure.
And then a few weeks ago, there I was in New York for an exhibition, beautiful, with Vogue, Italian, Christie's, about sustainability, which is our responsibility, I feel.
Yes, yes.
And I had a few days left, and I said, okay, let me go to absorb some culture.
So you went to the Met.
I went to the Met, and I entered, and I saw Canova pieces, and I couldn't believe. And then there was this exhibition about jewelry, and one entire wall about 19th century jewelry was dedicated to Saulini. And I dropped from the chair. I was there, like, speechless. I took pictures and I said, oh my God, I had a treasure in my hand,
like,
and I don't even know what I had. And then I say, okay, let's wrap it up, this masterpiece, that the treasure, hidden treasure that I didn't even know about, that I had in my hand, and create a romantic piece honoring Saulini, Canova, Tolvalzen, for a modern woman that wants something really special.
Okay, Alesso. Thank you. Alessio.
Thank you.
Oh my gosh, I can say the last name, but not the
You can
name.
Say anything. It's so romantic in any case, the way you pronounce.
Okay, well, Alessio, thank you so much for
your
time.
You.
I was just so appreciate it, and it was just so wonderful.
Thank you so much.
Mwah. The Italian way.
Yes.